Okay, so let's start right now. And before we dive into Houdini, I just want to take a few minutes into Photoshop. And I'm just going to take a picture of Ivy. That way we can start to plan ahead what we are going to do. And I just took the most generic Ivy I could find. And before we start thinking about how we are going to do this in Houdini, I kind of want to think about how I would do this without Houdini. Okay, so the first step usually when doing something like this would be to actually model the leaves, okay? You would start by modeling some high poly leaves. I'm just going to draw two of them. So A and B, and you could have like, I don't know, seven or six of them. I'm just going to make two here. And the next step after that would be to actually create the structure of the ivy, so the branches. And I'm just going to roughly draw one. And this kind of high poly geometry, you could create it in Max, for example, with in 3ds Max with some splines. Or even in ZBrush with a Z sketch tool, and I'm going to call them branches. And once we have all of this, usually the next step would be to just take the leaves and start copying them and placing them by hand on the branches. Let me just take a new layer for this, and you would do something like this: take one, copy it, and just rotate them until everything feels natural. And you would even alternate between your different leaves. That way you have a more natural feeling. And even in 2D, as you can see, it's a pretty long process. But in 3D, it's even longer. So what I want to talk right now is how we are going to manage to do this in Houdini. The branch, let me just keep this one like this. So the leaves and the branch, you will see that they will be pretty easy to do in Houdini. Actually, the branch will be really fun. We will actually draw them with a really nice tool. But I want to talk about how we are going to scatter the leaves onto the branches. And for that, let me just take another color. And I'm going to create like some blue. I'm going to call them spawn. Okay, those are going to be spawn points. And I'm just going to explain you the way we are going to do this in Houdini. So that way when we arrive to this part, you will understand why we are doing what we will do. And the way we will do it, we'll just create a bunch of points around here. Just randomly scattered around the branches. And this won't be enough, because if we just start with this and try to copy the leaves onto the branches, what will happen? Let me just show you what will happen. Let's say we say to Houdini, okay, Houdini, please copy the leaves onto the points. And Houdini will do something like this, which is definitely not what we want. So unfortunately, just having the spawn points won't be the ideal solution for us. What we need on the spawn point, is another kind of information. And this information, I'm going to draw it in yellow. I'm going to call it direction. What does that mean? That means on each of the spawn points, we are going to create a direction. This will be a vector. And we'll try to make it flow along the curve. So this way it will have a kind of a natural feeling. And this will be actually stored into an attribute in Houdini. And with that, what can we do? Now, with this information, if we try to say to Houdini, okay, take the leaf, please, and copy it onto the directions, onto the spawn points, it's going to try and sample the direction and make everything follow nicely. That way, instead of having what we had before, we will end up with something more like this. So it will copy the leaves and try to follow direction. And this sounds simple in 2D, but you will see that in Houdini there is some kind of setup to do before we can do all of this. Hopefully you can understand where I'm going with this. And the nice thing about doing it in 2D like this is if you just realize what we just did here, we tried to see how we could do this without Houdini and try to extract some procedural rules about this, which is something I do a lot of time when I'm doing procedural modeling. I will try to do it by hand and then extract the rules. So with this done, let's try to go right into Houdini, and we are going to start with the leaves. And yeah, see you.